Okay, so the foster mom wrote, Knox has been living with his current foster family for 2 months after being surrendered from his first owners. He was purchased from a breeder at 3 months old. He's thinking he sees something on the floor over here. And he does have a prey drive, so forgive him. I don't know what it is.
You see a bug. Is there a bug?
It's not bug season. Okay, I'm going to go ahead while Bev gets him settled down here and convinces him there's nothing over there. The previous owners didn't care for him appropriately. He was left outside on a chain in their backyard day and night, 24/7, 365 a year. He was provided with very little stimulation and would frequently escape, sometimes getting picked up by nearby neighbors or the local animal control. He'd never been neutered, microchipped, or even given an appropriate collar. He was never housebroken or properly crate trained. I'm going to come back to that in a minute. His crate was used as punishment, a timeout zone when he was in trouble, or when visitors didn't like him, so his family would put him in his crate to keep him separated from people. Obviously, he no longer has a positive association with crates. Now, Bev did point out, at some point here, the girl says that they were bringing him into the house for intervals and he was doing real well. She had to keep her cat separate, so that was a problem. But Bev said when she got him out of his kennel and took him outside, he pottied right away. So he's keeping his kennel clean, and that's a great indication. They wrote, his previous owners were a very busy family that was frequently gone from the house and or out of town for days at a time. The family reported that he broke their fence, would chew through his cables, and find all means to escape their yard. Well, I mean, if you're on a chain 24/7, I think that's a very natural thing to do. However, they did not realize these behaviors were likely due to understimulation, lack of attention, care, and boredom. The most recent time he escaped from their yard, he ended up being returned to his now foster family's home. It was a rainy day. Calm down, buddy. Knox was covered in mats and burrs, and the owners hadn't been seen in days. When we were able to contact them, the foster family offered their assistance to take Knox in as a foster to help him find a different home, as it appeared they were having difficulty caring for him. After a week of deliberation, in which Knox did return to his previous owners, they graciously accepted our offer to help, stating they'd been considering selling him as they didn't have the time he required to provide good care. Instead of selling him on puppy.com as they were planning before the offer to foster, they gave Knox to his now foster family with all his possessions, including the doghouse he used in their yard. At the time of surrender, Knox weighed 51 pounds, was not up to date on any vaccines or preventative medications, had not been neutered. They said he wouldn't allow them to groom him. You've been plucking a little bit. So I don't think he minds that. And he does need a grooming right now. You can see that coat's coming out. All he needed was some TLC, she wrote. In only 2 months with his foster family, his coat is full and not free, allowing his foster mom to brush him several times a week. So she worked on him with that. He's up to 55 pounds, eating 2 meals a day with extra additives to increase his intake. He goes on a two-mile walk every day with his foster mom, has daily play sessions off-leash in the backyard, which is surrounded by a 6-foot privacy fence, with the whole family, and is provided with an insulated doghouse as well as access to an indoor-outdoor porch to improve his living conditions while we try and find a good home for him. Due to the increase in exercise, stimulation, and safety precautions, he has not attempted to escape the new living arrangement at all. As all husky lovers know, though, even the most content husky is an escape artist by his or her nature. When alone in the fence yard, he is still attached to a long leash to reduce his risk of escape and injury. This woman was so amazing. I've got to say, I was wishing she was closer to here so we could get her as a volunteer. She's talking about the high prey drive, interest in the cats. Bear with me and just look at his beautiful face.
Loves those ears, right?
Oh, he's a pretty boy. The foster family took him to a good vet to get updated on all his vaccines, begin heartworm and flea tick preventative, and assess for any health conditions, as he had been had a very limited health history provided from his previous owners. His current vet found that his, he had a tricky neuter surgery because of testicular location. Let's see. Oh, they also did a gastropexy where they tack the stomach to prevent bloat. They do it like in Great Danes and stuff, like real big. Yeah, okay. Yeah, well, their vet recommended it. He's very comfortable coming in and out of an indoor-outdoor porch without behaviors, without peeing on the carpet or any signs of anxiety being indoors. With the cats put away in a separate room, he now comes inside the home for short periods during the day to be acclimating to indoor living. He has warmed up so well to coming inside that he now walks in without a leash or any signs of fear or distress. He's doing very well going on small car rides around town. While still unsure during the ride, he'll calmly sit in the front passenger seat next to his foster mom, happy to be with his people. He's being socialized with other dogs, and while he's doing very well with that, he is still learning doggy manners as he frequently attempts to assert his dominance by mounting. He's never once been noted to demonstrate, I don't know how that's going here, by the way, as an aside. You might ask the adoptions coordinator if he plays with other dogs here. I don't know if I've seen him mentioned in a play group. His only agitation towards a person was early on fostering when she was cutting knots off of his legs, and he kind of swung his head around to tell her to quit that. Now he has no mats in his fur, permits the grooming several times a week, which is important for a dog with a woolly coat like this. I mean, they can get messy and matted up so fast. His foster family absolutely loves him and only wants the best life for him. He's always happy, playful, and very loving. They'd like to keep him themselves. However, they truly believe he should be an inside dog with a family that doesn't have small animals. All he wants is love, attention, and to be with his people after spending so much of his early life alone. He craves all the love and attention. This is pretty redundant. No small animals. They think maybe a little older children, because he will jump up like you just see him doing with Beb. They had a 5-year-old daughter that he really liked. He happily runs with her in the yard, plays with toys. It's just simply due to his size and high energy that they said he might unintentionally knock over a little kid. If you decide to meet or have an interest in Knox, She left a really nice journal about him that'll come with him. Diane, our volunteer, said, look at his folder when you get there. The woman who saved him wrote a really beautiful journal about him, and it matches our experiences with Knox. He's very friendly and gets along super well with other dogs. He makes the most of his time in the play yard, running around, husky playing with the other pups, and coming to us for pets and treats. Sorry, I lost my focus there. Considering the life he lived for his first 3 years, he is amazingly well-behaved and socialized. He does need some leash work, as he was never taken for walks until he went into the foster situation, but seems eager to please, so hopefully will not be hard to rein him in. This dog has immense, huge potential, and it sure sounds like it. I mean, coming from being a chain dog outside and acting like he is here today, He clearly learns in new situations, wants to make you happy, just needs to learn to be everything you want in a dog. And he's already most of the way there, right? So I'm going to walk
out. Yeah, he's a nice boy. Very much energy.
Yeah. Hey. That's okay. There we go. Can I have a kiss? Good boy. Oh, good boy.